Hi everyone, this is Thomas Hopp speaking from the product management team here at Qlik, and welcome back to my series of presentations. And today's presentation here is about Qlik Sense Enterprise Client Manager or Windows platform. And we do have a couple of new capabilities within the upcoming September 2020 release that I wanted to talk about with you here today, and I will show you a couple of them as well. So let me just start here by covering, you know, the three areas that I will talk about. So again, for the Qlik Sense Enterprise Client Managed platform, we do deliver a couple of new things. So the first item here is about the app distribution monitoring as part of the QMC. So this is something that we definitely wanted to deliver to make it easier and better to follow when apps are distributed from your Windows platform into a SaaS tenant. So how do you manage and how do you monitor? So what is actually happening with those? And the second one is like a first step in improving the hub. So we're going to introduce a table view in the hub, which makes it easier to see a lot of files on one page. And last but not least, and that's something that I'm going to talk about here only and not do it in the demo, but the NFS support. So meaning like Linux-based files that's supported now. So for instance, that makes it way easier to use the default storage that comes, for instance, within a Google Cloud Platform installation. So again, instead of just SMB, so we do support NFS storage in here as well. And you will find like more details and how you kind of configure and implement this as well within our help pages as well. So let's do a quick demo here as well of the first two bullets. So I do have a tenant here. So first thing is about the app distribution improvements. So when I'm jumping to the QMC first, so they're going to the start page here on the left hand side, you know, you see there's an app distribution status menu. So when I click on this, I see all the apps that I've been distributing already, and there's a status on that, right? So I can see if those distributions are successful or not. And when I distribute a new app, so I'm picking the THP demo app here, I do a right click. As we know, I publish the app into my everyone stream here, and doing that publishing now, and that will then trigger a new distribution. So when I'm refreshing this kind of page here, so you see there's a new one and says in progress, and that's actually, you know, what this is. So it will hopefully will be successful in the second. There you go. So it's success, meaning the app then shows up on my cloud tenant. And if you need to configure this, so that's another one. So on the lower right, you see there's a link to the multi-cloud setup console itself. So there's no need for you anymore to remember the URL. So you can easily click on this and then open up your cloud console. So in case you have to do some more investigation to figure out, you know, then you can go from here. So this is my environment, the one that I'm using. So, but that's really where this link is all about here, that it makes it easier for you to jump from your QMC to the multi-cloud setup console. So that's the app distribution improvements on that end. And then last but not least, I did mention the table view, but here's only one app. So let me go into the everyone stream. So there we have at least two apps. Top right here, you have now like one more icon. So previously it was only the grid view and the list view. So what we now have is the table view. So I can switch it into that one, which gives you a couple of more details. And again, this is the first step. So there's more, you know, stuff planned here. And one is definitely as well about, you know, you managing tasks and all the stuff as well within the hub, and therefore again the table view is important. So that's concluding the demo for what we're going to deliver here from a backend perspective in the upcoming September release within our Qlik Sense Enterprise Client Managed environment, which is again our Windows platform. And hopefully that was useful, and talk to you in the next demo. Bye for now.